to mute the YouTube. Okay. What? Hello, Alicia.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
What brings you here? Can you introduce yourself?
Sure. My name is Alicia, and I've been searching for help with my galactic languages. Mm-hmm. And so that's really what led me to you. I posted in a different group. I posted in a lot of groups, and nobody can seem to lead me anywhere or help me with anything. And then someone gave me your name, and so I looked you up, and I was just shocked at the amount of information in the YouTube different channels. And so I was just really happy. And then I wrote you last night, and you responded, and that just
wonderful. Thank you. Let's speak galactic languages. So you don't mind, it will be published, right? You don't mind?
Oh, no, that's fine. I'm going to actually go upstairs so my husband can finish shipping and we won't bother anybody.
Wow. Thank you.
So we were talking about the humans, and I agree with you, Alex. Do you think, man, that the humans are the lowest, the soul in a human form? I'm talking about the human form, the world, what we live here. You know, the vehicle what we have on this planet.
Yeah, that's interesting how the alien souls get trapped on Earth and then produce a lot of complexity, but on a very low level. So it's not that humans are not smart, but they're smart in a very complex, lowered level. So people like, I just experienced it recently. There is a talented person with beautiful soul, but so much pressed into the material life that all the complexity they can handle is on the same level of material, on the same material level. They can have built very complicated structures in their mind, but they prohibit themselves from lifting up. They use all the talent which they got in fears and anger, and remembering what is what and who is who. So it is the same beautiful mind just squeezed into 3D.
Yes.
But I guess if he was incarnated in an alien world, he would become more harmonious, more positive, and he would feel just fine.
Yes.
So it's I wouldn't just lower the esteem of humans, especially the enlightened humans. I think we are very similar to the aliens, and it doesn't really help to look at the aliens up. It's nice to revere them, but not very far up. I think I really cherish the idea to relate to very highly developed aliens and angels and avatars of God on equal level. Then you can relate, then you can connect and plug in. So it's more like the love of a child to a parent or a child to grandparent. So we are still related, we are still very close. It's not a huge distance. It is a distance, but it is not huge.
Well, I agree with that. I was talking and I agree with you. I've maybe phrased the human, I would consider 3D box entity living in the 3D box. That's what called a human. We only have the human label for our planet, I assume. So that's what I call the vehicle limited or controlled or depressed or oppressed. And that's why we as a soul entering that vehicle of a human, we are the one, how you're saying, like a pancake, like we are not expanding, you know. So I agree with you.
Thank you. Yeah. So we have Starik joined. Starik, do you want to speak to us? No. So Alicia, are you still with us? Somehow should you
I am, yes. I'm finally settling down now, so.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. Yeah, let's speak some languages. Let's lift the vibration. I will just do the chant, and then you can join, and Lila, you can join too. The intention of the moment is to connect on a galactic languages level. The intention is to invite the angelics, invite the spirits, invite the aliens to speak the higher level of the truth and bring the harmony to this gathering. Ayyuhanna halla 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 ullaham ullaha urahanna ayyuhanna humma humma ayyuhanna humma humma ullayyuhanna. Alicia, you can follow.
Ashanakita ayu to aimatikion like aya, but ayawat hai nana e kuta li kuta aima hao. Chikute ayumata eo hoyopta o da yashuna tikula ayu mahito hayo shona ti tatatatai dot ai. Ushano kito dai bonahita yoya ganant chikoya, but the oya mahia hoyu tu. Machita tu.
Okay, act, amkt, ay, al, al, amahat, araya, rahana, amt, ya act, ok, rahana, anta, hana.
Shaka do aya mata hai, the lucky you meant to do aya, but do aya.
Do you have a translation?
I do not. No, I do not.
What language is that?
I only wish I knew. I was told that it was the Anra, which would be a combination of Anunnaki, Sirian, Arcturian, and there was another one, another A. So I'm trying to, because I can speak it. I don't have to meditate. I don't have to. I can just speak it. I can answer somebody. I don't really know what I'm saying, but I'm assuming I'm just answering as my mind's thinking in English, it's translating. So yeah, I'm just really interested in learning more about it. And I've just been very different my whole life. So this is where I've been trying to find family, and I'm really excited. I feel really, for the first time in a long time, I feel really open, like my heart chakra just went boom, and it's just overflowing with joy, so.
Wow. Yeah, I don't know the name of the language either, but it sounds very familiar. I heard it before, and I sort of can connect to it. Let's try translation. Can you count from 1 to 20? Can you try?
Shutu. Okay, here we go. Shutu ahi tala tuma foto katita a bono ho kita a napata. I don't know if that's quite 20.
That's all right. Perfect. Thank you. Can you say mama?
Nacha.
Can you say papa?
Tokna.
Can you say I love you?
Namihitu.
Wonderful. Can you say thank you?
Taku.
Can you say you're welcome?
Matika.
Can you say blessed be one God?
Machikota u tami ita I.
Wonderful. Lila, join me with the phrases to translate. It's perfect to build in a dictionary. It's like Rosetta Stone.
Yeah, this is, I didn't know I could, I mean, I would do this in my head, but I've never actually done it.
Yeah, let's learn, because it's very rare to have the translation. So I don't understand you. Can you translate? I don't understand you.
Makukatina mita ukalau.
Translate. What language is this?
Tamakita iota.
I love speaking this language. This connects me to my higher friends.
Takina ti to ma I to ai pata a makuta ia.
Can you sing a child song to a child, like a nursery rhyme or something?
Maybe like Jack and Jill. That's the only one I can think of right now. So, Daki na pa ita o tu daki ta ne patayo ta water. Dakta da mandika tao ta baita da matia.
Wonderful. Is there anything you can channel from them? Some kind of a prayer, a chant, a blessing, or a song?
Kote I mahito ai pa kita mika I ampa tita I tu ami hita. Kutam tika bla aio kutam na ia pa I yuta mahi plekata I mata a hukita ma.
Wonderful. Thank you. Let's keep some words coming. So how do you call Earthens in that language? People from Earth.
Gai?
Uh-huh.
Like, or I guess, to me that's like Kai, K-I, Gai.
Okay. Lila, go ahead.
What? Somehow,
that's all right. So, Ayakt om kai yakat ana ola akt yamaha. Can you translate what I'm saying? It would be interesting. Hold on, I will bring something in, some image. Ayaha om my akt ala han a hura akata ya una ala 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 ayukata makra hana kata yukat yumahata yaka yuna akt aura ura ura yana agro. Gaila alna uma hala hala yana uma umana.
It was okay. A lot of ala.
I don't know. Yes, possibly.
I'm going to take a stab at it and I'm probably totally wrong. Something about I am part of the Arcturian, but I'm in this body, something, I don't know. I have no idea.
Lila, did it get any sense in that?
No.
I don't want to spoil anything, but it was something else. It was something else. It was more about praise to God.
Okay. This is where I lack, and I want to learn. I want to learn how to do
Me
it.
Me too. We want to learn to translate the languages. Also, we want to... to develop telepathy. I was at the seminar 2 days ago, and there was a teacher who was asking questions to the audience, and usually the audience couldn't answer, and I was thinking, can I just use telepathy to guess what is in her head, what is she projecting? So that was an interesting exercise in telepathy. Like, very frequently she would ask a question, what's that word, what's the next step, and I don't think I ever guessed it right, but I guessed a little bit closer maybe. But it was always unexpected. So developing telepathy would be one of our next steps.
That's how I prefer to... I have a college degree, and so I, in the beginning, I was really good with like thesaurus words and speaking all educated, and it's gone now. I would rather prefer to just have someone know what I'm thinking. And I always think I know what other people are thinking instead of communicating verbally with me. But then when it jumps to that other languages, that's where I'm stuck.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it comes so easily through you. It's
natural.
It is a good sign that you could easily channel. Okay. I think channeling would be very easy for you, but you don't rush it. But at some point when you're not recording for broadcast, you might want to channel to me or someone else to answer the questions and like what language is that and things like that. I don't want to force you now, but.
No, it's okay.
Ask me questions about us and I will be happy to tell you about our community. What do you want to know?
Well, how did the community start?
Oh. Okay, it started with a sort of deception. I don't think I ever said it that clearly, but it was a deception. So the prehistory was that, what's his name? Steve Beckoff. Yeah, Steve Beckoff, in 2012, he got a message through a channeler that the aliens could pick people for a visit on a ship. And it was, he already had a community, except it wasn't that much open. It was much close, more closed. We are a very open community. So he had his friends, and in online community, he said, who wants to go? And I think there was a number. They can take 100 people for a visit to the ship.
Okay.
In 2012. And like thousands of people signed up. I think I was within maybe 300, but I didn't make in the first 100 to sign up. It took me, I would say, maybe 1 hour to realize, absolutely, I want to go. Like 1 hour, it was like, should I put my name there? Is it dangerous? Is it real, right? And, you know, what the hell, you know, if I put it, maybe next time we'll take it. So after an hour, I decided I want so much, I can put the danger aside and sign up online. So there was a lot of discussion, and closer to the date when they were supposed to pick up people, Beckoff became very nervous. He said, you know, guys, if you lied through a channeler, if you don't stand by your word, you know, I will quit. And at the due time, they didn't pick up anyone. It just didn't happen. It was sort of expected, right? You know, miracles don't happen that often, and such beautiful miracles. So I learned my lesson, and the aliens channel later said it was a lesson for resilience for Beckoff, for Steve, whatever it means. So meaning let, you know, do you still believe if we fail you, do we still believe in the principles? Or, you know, so I had that experience later with my friends, but same thing happened to us when I was channeling. I was with Jim, and Jim was channeling. I was asking questions. After a few months, starting from I think May to September, so 4 months of channeling, we developed a relationship, and I proposed the human colonies. I wrote the whole book by that time. I wrote my book with a proposal of human colonies, meaning take us there, and from there we will help the first contact and the ascension. You need us humans from Earth to be helping you, the aliens, to do the work. And I know there is already some humans working with the aliens, but these are more of military type or managers type or financial type. They're working kind of or like secret agent type. But I propose that take us civilian light workers. That's what would take the civilian light workers to your settlement. And what we'll do the broadcast through YouTube and help the Earth to transform through us reporting what we see up there. It's kind of like obvious decision, right? You know, Just obviously that's what is missing. There is no broadcast from the aliens directly. There is only through channelings. And the messages through channelings are also very kind of narrow in certain ways. They allow certain things, but don't allow other things. So if we humans come, we would broadcast differently, right? We would broadcast much more in a grounded way. Mm-hmm. So I proposed to them, and the curse said, yes, we invite everybody to apply. I said, how about we just set up application system like Beckoff had, just open, anybody can apply to go. And I created email, signuptogo@gmail.com. It still works, signuptogo@gmail.com. Okay, so that's the email, very, very easy, signuptogo@gmail.com. It still works. The aliens still check it. So if you are listening, you can apply and they can check your email. And very often when people apply, what happens is they get an interview at that night. So they get a very vivid dream where some sort of glowing figures come and speak to you. And many people had that visitation. They didn't understand it was interview. It was just some very friendly person would chat with them for the whole night. So many people reported that. But very few people reported actually being taken after that. I guess one of the brightest reports is from Star Traveler. She kind of remembers more than others. But basically, they promised us that they will take us and we will remember. And that never happened. So most people don't remember their visits or remember so vaguely, can easily confuse it with a dream. Mm-hmm. Like few times I was, had dreams which looked like it could have been I was there. But I, you know, there is that mechanism when you wake up, you remember everything and then in a few minutes you remember nothing except a few words. You kind of, well, if you describe your dream to yourself in words, then you remember these words, but not the dream itself. Mm-hmm. Like I remember once I was very happy holding a baby, and then later I asked through the channel, was it my baby? And they said yes. So that one image, the flash of me holding a baby and being happy about that was like all I remembered. But some people remember lots more. So what I'm saying, it started with a deception. It is, when I posted it, I sort of made a leap of faith and gave some, some trust, that is a word, gave trust to the alien, channeled alien message, but I wasn't sure it was real. And some of it is real. It's kind of, it is repeatedly happening. There is spiritual guidance for sure, but people expected physically to be taken for a visit. And I don't think anybody was taken like physically who reported, you know, being there physically. So part of that was, so people expected physically, but they were taken more like astrally. So that's the main deception, main disagreement, main misunderstanding. But I got a lot of spiritual help of building that community. There were two people in the beginning and continue till that day. It's me and Jim. And Jim is very highly spiritual. He is absolutely talented channeler who can easily channel very, very variable sources very easily. He can tap in very easily. It was a huge transformation for him. First, they remade his body. He was upgraded in many ways. He was like in pain. They kind of upgrade his voice, his chakras. He was like, a lot of transformation happened. So, but he was kind of, he understood what was happening. So he just went through that gracefully. And then they upgraded his soul. So now he has a different soul. So it's not the same gene we had 3 years ago. So he got plugged in into a new higher self. And I was plugged into a new higher self. So both of us are have been transformed in many ways. But Jim goes way higher than I. He is like, if you measure that in numbers, he is around oscillating between 5 and 7.
Okay.
This area, 5th chakra, 7th chakra, and I'm still oscillating between 3.5 and 5. 3.5 and 5. So basically, he's like 1.5 chakras higher than I, and that's a huge difference. But there is lots of people like me, like in Lightworkers, and like Jim, it's very few.
So
yes, go ahead.
I was going to say, so a couple things. I astral travel a lot. Like I don't sleep very well at night because I'm always like doing work in other planes and stuff. But when I was little, so my story is really strange and I'm not going to like bother you guys with it now, but, I was adopted and everything is just weird. I don't have much written down about it. And, I was talking to a galactic historian and my joke is that I was just dropped off from a ship. And she's like, well, that's actually true. And she didn't know that when I was little, I actually had a ship come up and check on me all the time. I don't see it now very often, but so yeah, I'm really familiar with a lot of that stuff. And I've had a lot of DNA upgrades in the past year. The one in my spine was absolutely horrible. Absolutely horrible. I think I still have pictures of the mark that it left because my body was just not incorporating it very well. But yeah, this is very, very exciting.
Were you born on Earth? You're not sure, right?
I don't know. I honestly don't know. I have a journal that was kept by the lady who I was supposedly in foster care with before my parents adopted me. And there's no mention of like anything. Like I think that there's like the adoption agency must work with the aliens to incorporate these children, these alien children into homes. And then they have like this, you know, falsified story of like where they, but you would think that in my baby books and stuff, I would have like blood types written down. I would have all the information written down because my mom kept, my adoptive parents kept tons and tons of books about, you know, my first word and stuff like that, but nothing about like blood type, nothing about where I came from. I went to search for my original birth certificate and it was just blockade after blockade back and forth. And finally this one place said that they had the original one, but that I didn't have access to it because my original parents never signed a form and that I have to take it to court. It's just, so I just stick to the story that, you know, I was dropped off by a stork or something.
Anybody, do you have questions? Go ahead.
You can find Alicia in the through the channeling when you mark on some time. You can just get a session with him and he can tell you who you are. That's very easy.
Who I am, like galactically, or who I am human?
No, the human we know, you're Alicia. galactically, who your parents are. Just about your soul journey, you can find that out.
That would be nice because that's what I'm really interested in. And it's not so much to like live in the past, even though, you know, time's not linear.
It's not about the past. It is about who you are, because when you know who you are, you can access to the consciousness of you, the higher self, every self. And then you're going to be happy and nobody is going to put you down, not even you, because you're going to be happy about yourself. And I'm then you're so going good. To conquer the world.
This because is all we've been saying. Yeah,
right?
This is what I've been saying, that it's not about living in the past. It's about finding who you are as a whole, as a collective, and collecting all your pieces. And there's so many people who like, shoot you down and they're like, oh, like you live in the past and that's not good. And I'm like, no, like you guys just don't get it. But thank you for like confirming that with my whole belief system of the importance of that.
From the Vedic culture, I can give a very short explanation about living in the past. There are three ways of living. Living in the past means ignorance. Living in the future means passion, and living now means goodness. So there is a difference in living where you live. Living now, that is the way to go, and that's the goodness. This is the best way of living. But without past, you don't have a now, so you should know who you are, because this is you. And this is all because we are disconnected from the past. You know, on other levels, we don't need to go to the past because we are in the now. Mm-hmm. But because in we are in the 3D, so we are formed in the box, in the human vehicle, that's why we should know, we don't remember. So that's the point. The past is a past or part of now.
Yeah, I believe that we create our past. And if we believe in a certain part, in a certain story of our origin, it manifests through from now into the past. We're basically creating the past now. So yeah. When people say, what is percent of my DNA? And Bashar never answered that questions, this kind of questions. He says, what if I say you such and such? Would you get excited? And basically, you create your alien origins now. If you learn about, say, being a Pleiadian and that makes you feel really good, that past materializes and your body in the now changes by accepting these Pleiadian codes. As you accept that past, it becomes part of your story. Basically, we live in a synthetic matrix, the program, the sophisticated, very complex and strong computer program. And we are players in this program. And when we accept the new past, the program adapts to that. Because we are running that program in our soul. Our soul is bigger and is capable. It's like a huge computer which can plug in different codes and different programs in it. And as you connect to, say, to a new higher self, as you connect to the new story of your creation, you connect to the new story of the Earth's creation, yeah. that program of the now changes. So you like things that look similarly, but because that program is plugged in, the now changes and the future changes, how things react to your life, and you get more and more proofs that becomes materialized. And if you forget about something, like I had a lot of channelings or psychic readings when things just didn't resonate with me, and I kind of made the check mark. Yeah, that's interesting, but it's nothing I want to connect. So you have the right to refuse what you have said in a psychic reading. Say somebody said to you that you are like 100% reptilian, and then you say, no, I don't want it. And you are not. That's in most cases that's simple. I have a friend who is fascinated with the idea of flat Earth. He finds lots and lots of proofs that the Earth is flat. And for me, it's kind of a little bit too much. I can adjust to many ridiculous ideas, but flat Earth is just a little bit too much because, you know, I know like airplanes fly. I know how the sun rotates. Mm-hmm. Actually, sun moves in the sky, right? So for me, to come back to the idea of flat Earth is a little bit, requires too much of adjustments in my model of world. But I realized that for many centuries, the humans on Earth lived with the idea of the flat Earth. It was kind of a common understanding, like especially in middle centuries, like 10th century. So these were real souls which were played, which were building the program of Earth. So that was, the matrix was coded. So a lot of programs were written at that time by these souls and the helpers of these souls, which included the flat Earth model. So this program is still part of our collective thinking pattern of our Akashic records. So it is, so the program of this matrix is combined of lots of different pieces which don't fit well together. So flat Earth programs are still here. So if you connect to them, they're true for you. It's mm-hmm. right. it's called monism in philosophy, but that's you know, that life is a dream is the principle. So in this dream we have programs which are plugged in, and flat Earth is some programs which are still here. When you walk on the Earth, you can easily use the program which was working at the time when people were thinking that Earth was flat. So these programs, they don't take into account that the Earth is round. Like if you are on a flat surface, these programs are still working. They kind of adapted. Like remember in 2000, we had that problem of that, you know, the, how do you call it?
The
Y2K? Yeah, Y2K problem, where the lots of financial and energy grid software was written without thinking what will happen after them, after 2000. So, and we live in a matrix which still has lots of flat earth programs just plugged into the system, and they kind of made to work together. So you wanted to say something?
Well, I was going to say, from my experience, I started helping people cross over at a very young age. For everybody, it happens differently. I have a friend who helps the police department solve like cold cases with her ghosties that like hang out with her and help her to solve their cases. And we do a lot of talking back and forth. So for me, I do most of the work at night and they come differently. Sometimes they're hanging out on my bed. Sometimes they're just colors of light. You know, where for her, a lot of times they're like actually standing there. So I think for everybody, it just is different in how you perceive. Like she can hear her guides. They talk to her in their own voices, but I can't hear that. They send me signs. They send me numbers. They send me thoughts, and that's how it works. So I think for everybody, it's very different. I mean, that's what makes humans humans.
Oh. I wanted to ask you, Alicia, so about this police work, how does it go?
For my friend, basically, Well, when it happened the very first time, she didn't really know who she could turn to because the woman wanted help with
the kids. I lost you. Do you understand that?
Yay.
And she actually had a old cop friend of hers that he kind of knew her abilities. And so she confided in him and he said, well, I know someone else who's going to trust you. And then it kind of built from there. So she built herself a line of like cop trustees or investigator trustees. And now if they have an issue, they can come to her, or a lot of times there's a website out there that has all these cold case files and you can go through them. So if somebody says, if they come to her and they say, you know, my name is so-and-so and I need help, then she can go on that file and she can see if, you know, they have some evidence or whatever, and then she can contact her peoples. I don't know. It's very interesting, but she's helped solve quite a few cold cases.
So it isn't so. Yeah. So ascension, if you don't mind. Alright. Galaxy. Solar system. Star.
Shuti.
Flying ship.
I don't know.
All right, that's fine. telepathy.
Shakita iana o the yola iana ha.
Oh wow, that's a long word.
Oh boy.
Food.
Food, was that it?
Mm-hmm.
Shudinaya. Shudinaya. Sustenance.
Water.
Kaya.
Okay. Fire.
Shutia.
Mm-hmm. Energy.
Chi.
Wow.
That's weird.
Health.
Shutaya.
Healing.
Shigina.
Do.
Doom.
No, do.
Oh, do.
Just do it.
Jedi, yeah. So I get die. Die would be do.
Oh, thank you. Don't.
Doa. Doa.
Okay. Is.
She-e. She-e.
Thank you. Isn't.
She. I don't know.
Okay. Isn't. There should be some way to translate it. How about not? Not, no.
Hook.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
She, like uh-huh. S-A-P, that's kind of weird.
Okay, stop.
Shutu.
Start.
Shutai.
Mm-hmm. I.
Ika.
You.
Uku.
Thank you. Friends.
I don't know. Friends. Okay, so. Shanamaka. No, I don't. I'm gonna skip that one.
All right. Let's be friends. How about let's be friends?
Shataiya. It's something like iya or something. Shataiya. Let's be friends. Shataiya.
Uh-huh. God.
I don't know.
Thank you.
I think spirit? I'm saying cluster now.
spirit.
Shatina.
Thank you.
Money.
Money. It was in my list.
Money. I don't have a word for money.
Good.
We don't have a word for money, I guess.
No money there.
matter.
I might be tapped out.
spirit guide.
Sanikaya.
Life.
Shutai.
Death.
Shutaiya.
Take me now. I'm ready. Can you just repeat? Take me now, I'm ready. That would be my favorite phrase. Okay. I'm from Earth's solar system.
I'm from Earth's solar system.
Thank you. I'm a light worker. I come with love and light. Thank you. I invite a healing.
Shanaki hoya humatido aya.
I would like to help. Thank you. I'm a friend of the Kerr. May divine energy be with you.
My divine energy.
No, may divine energy be with you. Okay. Just a blessing.
Okay. Tukanai taiya mahuka aya oiya taki o na chikwaiya pata. Apparently that's long.
Thank you. That's all I had for the list. Do you want to? I think I ran out of time. It's 2 hours now, but I would like to continue later. Let's schedule some other time.
Okay.
What is your availability? What's your everybody, what's your availability? How about, I think I have time on Thursday, maybe.
So this week is not good because we have Easter and church with the family. But next week would probably.
Yeah, next week is all open for now.
Okay, Let's do it sometime next week then. So whenever, I work from home, so it doesn't matter.
I guess next week, same time would be good, maybe. Yeah. I
think okay, so next today, week, is, so. Today is Tuesday, right?
Yeah, today is Tuesday.
It will be good to...
What was that?
No?
Yes?
Yeah, we can hear now.
You can?
Yes.
Yeah. I think the best thing is to choose at some point a regular time, a date, so people can schedule, you know? That's this idea.
Okay. I think Tuesday looks good so far.
Okay. And then time-wise, well, our time is different than your time.
I think today's time is just fine.
Okay. All right.
12 at noon.
Yeah, whatever it was today, I will just make it weekly. If I need to change, I will change. But I think what we have now is good.
Okay. And I have a picture for Staric. It's not very good because I don't draw anymore. I used to draw.
Uh-huh.
But this is what I wanted to show him.
Can you make a little closer? Move sure. A little closer.
It's a dog. It's a being. It's a being, but it's like a dog. Being that I've seen here and there in my travels, but not like an Anubis. It's different than Anubis. So, and I'm
okay.
Not
okay. It looks pretty similar to Anubis. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Egyptian.
Yeah, I don't think it. You know, I don't think it is. I think it's more dog-like, but. Then again, there's so much that I don't know. I see a lot of things on my travels and I don't always remember them. And then if someone talks about them, then the pictures come in my head. And so you just never know. But anyway, I said I would try and give it a try and see if I could show him what I remember seeing on one of my travels. So
Wonderful. I think we are done for today. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank
it was
you
a good
so
start. It was a good start. It's nice chatting with you both, with you everybody. And I will just do a little chant and we'll finish with that. Oh, Hanna, 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 Homma, Yaha, Homma, Homma, Oh, Hara, Hanna, Ayama, Hanna, 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 Homma, Oh, Homma, Haya, Hanna. Om Aiyam.